Hi everyone, this is LAR Games, and today I'm watching episode 2 of Infinite Dendrogram. Last episode? Well, he discovered his OP power for some reason. I think creating a system in a video game that develops organically like this is very prone to abuse. Like, it... If things are as random and as procedural as it wants us to believe, then of course things like this are going to happen, but they'd also be a lot more common. Combined with the opposite being incredibly common as well, with, you know, people receiving really unfortunate skills that don't work at all and don't really let people, like, survive. Unless, like I mentioned last time, it's governed by an AI that judges all of these things realistically. Which also might be the case, but in that case, things like this would never happen because it would, you know, judge it to be something that would mess with the balance of gameplay. that said, I do like my OP main protagonist, so I don't know why I'm complaining. I would just like it to be a little better explained. With that said, let's just get started and watch the second episode. So I wonder if these characters talking are some sort of program or players. Ah, yes, the King of Beasts. Lions have no chance against that. I haven't eaten today, so, Oh, anime food, why? This is pretty much the same technology as Sora Online. That would be so freaking cool. Like, spending hours in games and, like, coming back and only a little time has passed. Well, yeah. you wouldn't want her to change from that. Surpass the limits of the highest rank. It does seem he's been playing this game a long time. though, the fact that, like, time passes differently means that whoever's playing is already getting a big edge up on you. So this is like PvP stuff, right? I mean, you're not much worse. Or at least much better. You just changed your hair color. If I was you, I'd keep out of PvP 100% and just do PvE stuff, because that's so much more fun. Shouldn't that have been given to him automatically? Oh, we're skipping the conversation, huh? I've been playing Dragon's Dogma again a lot, and just seeing her there kind of makes me imagine her as being a pawn. And in Dragon's Dogma, you could totally make these two. Including waving around a giant sword. combat like that in a VR game, it's pretty satisfying. I just wish that, like, an actual RPG implemented it. Don't jump. What did I just say? Oh, God, no. Well, so that's quite a coincidence, meeting another person with a human, seeming... I forgot what they were called, so I'm just gonna call it a pawn. Alien? You know, in a regular game, you'd be a lot less surprised. You're like, oh, dang it, there's another one of those there. You know, if it was, like, pretty much unrestricted. Pretty much anyone who was not invested in the game would try killing other players. You gotta zigzag. You can't zigzag from that, so never mind. Well, being stronger isn't really a decision that you make. She's quite different from the other nemesis I know. From Tula Brew. And there's the one from Resident Evil. That's pretty different as well. Well, until the game's service ends. The time for that is coming even with my servants and Fate Grand Order, and that's going to be quite difficult. It's the biggest flaw with games as a service. How do you know about those things? Do you have access to the internet? She can move on her own. That means he could, like, toss her and have her fly through the air and stuff. I guess regular flesh is better. I wonder what level he is at this point. He's been able to take on higher level enemies than him for quite a while, so that would probably boost his experience gain quite a bit. Sure, building this up. Oh, just be an OP. How about you? Well, he said. You should give it a shot. Wait till he gets to a higher level. You know, I really like her. Alright, well, second episode. A lot happened in a very short amount of time. So I'm probably gonna have to go back and read the novel. I assume it's a novel. This feels very novelish. To fill in all of these gaps that have been kind of skipped over. Yep. Fun episode. I didn't expect the brother to kind of disappear for most of it now. I thought he was going to be part of, you know, a party, but I guess not. He's going pretty much solo with him and his pawn. yeah. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.